here. I have been explaining the two theories, that is maximum principal stress and maximum shear stress theory. In the maximum principal stress theory, what happens when your elastic stress is equal to the working stress, then the failure will occur. In this, it is the case of the ordinary cast iron and the brittle materials. For example, I have taken one example. The maximum working stress is 35 megapascal and the minimum working stress is 95 megapascal for the compression. So for the formula is there, when the elastic stress is equal to the working stress, then it will fail. So we take elastic stress into factor, elastic stress is equal to factor of safety into principal working stress. So we put the values for the elastic stress, that is the 220 megapascal, and working stress is 35 megapascal. We calculate the factor of safety for both the cases, tensile cases and the compression case. So out of these two one, we get the smaller value for the compression case. So that means the cast iron or the brittle material will fail due to the working stress in the compression stress. So that means this is the case where the failure will occur. Now I have cited a second example showing the same statements. It is not concerned that the elastic tensile strain will be same as in this case. It may vary. Elastic stress in the tension or compression may vary. Now we have taken a case of second case. It is S1 principal working stress is 40 megapascal, stress T is 100 megapascal. Now we have again finding out the factor of safety, that for which material it will for compression or tension which will fail earlier. So now in this case we have taken stress elastic equal to the factor of safety into working stress. We calculate the factor of safety for the tensile, similarly for the compression, and we get the value of factor of safety 2 for the tensile case. So now the material will fail due to the tensile stress. Okay. Now let us come to the maximum shear stress theory. This is the second theory which we have done in the class. Second maximum shear stress theory, failure will occur when the maximum when the maximum shear stress, that is tau max, in the complex system reaches the value of maximum shear stress in simple tension in the elastic limit. So we have taken this formula, stress tau max is equal to working stress maximum minus working stress minimum by 2, and that is the stress of tension by 2. Now for this case I have come out with this relation for the tau max. Now we take the principal working stress out of these two relations. We know from the torsion equation E over J is Fs by R equal to G theta by L. And for the second case we know M over I is stress B by R. We have calculated the value of torque. We have calculated the value of momentum. We know J is the polar moment of inertia. We found out the value of pi by 32 D4. Similarly, in the case of your movement equation, I is pi by 64. So we have taken and find out this relationship. Now, calculating the, we know the diameter is given in this case, 120 mm for the shaft, and we have calculated the value of torque, and we have calculated the value of torque, that is the shear stress and the bending stress. We have put these two calculated stress to find out the working stresses. Now, when we find out the working stress, we will put in this equation to calculate the simple tension stress. Now we calculate the value of the your torque. Torque value is 50.97, stress B, that is the bending stress, 70.7. We put these two values in these two equations to calculate the value of maximum working stress and minimum working stress. Now secondly, we have calculated the value of stress T. We have put this stress T into the again equation to calculate where the material will occur in the deformation. When the stress or when stress max reaches the value of maximum shear stress. So that means this was the value of tension calculated, the factor of safety. 220 divided by 137.5. What is this? So this